Welcome to Not Another White Box, the channel that brings you all that's cool, quirky and unusual in the caravan world. My name is Cameron and today I'm going to take you on a tour of my five top favourite new caravan designs that are available to buy in Britain today in 2024. We're going to start with a new entry, and this is a new one from Eriba that I got to take a closer look at the October NEC Caravan and Motorhome Show in 2023. This is the new Eriba Touring 642, and it's something quite unique about the interior, which I'm dying to show you because it's so unusual. You may have noticed straight away the pop-top roof is a lot higher than what you normally get on an Eriba, and that's a little bit of a hint of what we're going to find on the inside. Stepping in, you'll see there's plenty of headroom that you'd expect in an Eriba, and it's very kind of conventional Eriba, but I've got to say, the trim in here, the worktops, the wood, the upholstery is stunning. It's such a lovely, contemporary, modern, fresh, but also quite ageless colour scheme in here. It's got like a copper texture to all the worktops and tables. It's a British spec van, so here we are, full oven and grill, lost most of your storage. I'm going to start a survey and find out who actually uses these things, because it seems that a European van will not sell in Britain unless it's got one. And it's just a bit daft, really, because we seem to demand that all these caravans have one fitted. And speaking to a lot of people, they don't actually use the oven or grill, so we could maybe do without it. But at the back, we've got a fairly conventionally European fixed bed that has this little cutout in the middle. I call it the hand-holding bed because you won't be able to roll over to the middle and cuddle, but you can lay at the sides and hold hands. It's just something that's done in a lot of European vans. We don't seem to have it over here, but it does mean it's quite good for when you're getting up in the middle of the night. You can quite easily get in and out of bed quite comfortably. Here we've got the small little washroom, which again, not massive, but the quality and fit and finish of it is absolutely stunning. It's like a boutique hotel in here. I just love what Eriba have done. It's just fresh, it's modern, it's classy, it's stylish, and it's just beautiful. It's a place I want to go away on holiday, and it feels a little bit more special than a lot of other vans that are on the market. But I can't avoid it any longer. What is this up here? So if we switch places, I'll show you, because we've been hiding the fact that down here there is a ladder, because this is actually a double bed up here, and I'm just going to slowly move it forwards. It's very easy to fold down like so, and then I've got to climb up to the top, and I'll see you up there. Up here, there's room for two more people. It would probably be kids that would sleep up here, to be honest. If you're used to camper vans, then this just gives you the same kind of thing, but in a more conventional caravan format. And it's quite unique on the market. There's currently only Eriba and the Owenheimer Group that offer this kind of roof on a caravan. And I think as more and more people buy into the camper van phenomenon, we're probably going to see this gain a little bit of popularity. But 10 out of 10 for trying something different. I absolutely love it. And I think the caravan is really something very special. Oh, and with all the grace of a dumper truck, I'm going to exit the bedroom. And even with the bed down, you can still sort of stand up down here if you're getting up in the middle of the night, want to nip to the loo. But providing everyone's off the bed up top, you can just push it up and away it goes. That's German quality right there. It's just stunning. This caravan is fabulous. Personally, it's not something I would buy just because it just the concept isn't quite for me, but I completely understand the concept and know that there is a strong market out there for these, and it is fabulous. So well made, beautifully finished, wonderfully designed, and it shows why Eriba continue to be at the forefront of caravanning innovation. All these years later since their inception, they're just a timeless, fantastic design. Up next at number four, we have sort of a new spin on an old, firm Not Another White Box favourite, and it's the Swift Basecamp Evo concept. Today we're outside one of the absolute Not Another White Box staples, which is the Swift Basecamp 2. Now, if you watched any of my videos before, you'll know this is one of my absolute favorite vans built in Britain these days. And there's so many people who follow this channel who have one. But at the October 2023 NEC Caravan and Motorhome Show, there's a new model on the block. It's not a bigger one, it's not a shorter one. It's exactly the same caravan, but it's got a different name. It's called the Swift Basecamp Evo, and it's a completely new concept from Swift. And looks like a Basecamp, feels like a Basecamp, but this right here is the true future of caravanning. The Basecamp Evo at the moment is a concept, and it's only just been unveiled by Swift at the October 2023 NEC Caravan and Motorhome Show. And this to me really points to the future of where caravans need to be. There's over 700 watts of solar on the roof and a really powerful inverter that enables you to run this caravan completely off grid. Sustainability is the buzzword with this project, and aside from the power management, it also uses revolutionary new materials that massively cut down on the carbon footprint of this caravan, both in the manufacturing process, but also for the end user. Such clever ideas like collecting rainwater to use to top up the flush tank for the toilet, and even recycling plastic bottles to make the insulation. So much goes into this caravan to really make it a blueprint of how caravans should be manufactured in the future. Inside the new Basecamp Evo, again, it looks like business as usual in here, but the closer you look, it's not quite all as it seems. Immediately, the first thing I'm drawn to is the fact that the gas obviously has gone, so we've got an induction cooker. There's also an oven below, or microwave oven even, which obviously works off electric only. Elsewhere, it seems pretty conventional, except the fridge is a special Dometic unit that runs off electric only. There's no gas option on it. And you'll notice that they've even installed an air fryer, which air fryers are kind of a bit of a topical thing for someone my age, because one minute you get excited by going on a night out, next minute you're excited by air fryers, and it's a true coming of age experience. So it's interesting to see one inside the van. Because again, that's what a lot of people are using now in their caravans. And in a Basecamp kitchen, there's tons of room to put one on top. One of the things I've always loved about the Basecamp, ever since it was launched, is they always had these overhead lockers, which are actually fabric bags that just unzip like this. And you can access them quite easily and whatever's inside them, and then zip them up like a normal cupboard. But they're smarter than that. They unhook at the top and you can just take them out with you and take them home. And initially I thought, I want a proper cupboard, I don't want this. But then when I thought about it, how most of us use a caravan, we all put things in bags anyway and then decant them into cupboards. So why not just cut out the middleman and take the bags home and then hang them up inside the caravan, so everything's ready to use for your trip away. And it's this sort of clever design that turns conventionality on its head that I've always loved about the Basecamp range. And of course, in the Basecamp Evo, they're sticking with this. It's a well-established staple of the Basecamp range, except we've now got this lovely shade of blue. At the front end of the Basecamp, and it's business as usual here, you've got this lovely big lounge space that converts into a double bed. The fabrics feel lovely. They actually feel nicer than the standard Basecamp fabrics, and they're all recycled, ecologically sourced materials, which is just, I can't tell you how pleased I am to see someone in the caravan industry doing this, because my chagrin with the industry for so long has been the amount of single-use plastics and unsustainable sources for a lot of the materials that are used. So I think it's really important that Swift are trying this concept, and if they could bring it to market at a reasonable price, it would be a really, really, really good thing for the industry. Finally, we get to the back where we've got the washroom. And again, this is a pretty standard Basecamp 2 washroom, except of course, we've got that rainwater flush on the toilet, and the water is heated from the inverter using the solar on the roof to charge it. It's still a lovely washroom. We've got the heater output in here, got a nice big shower tray. We've got a nice ecologically sourced shower curtain, which is fantastic to see something that's different to those horrible plastic ones that just cling to you as soon as they get wet. So I've loved seeing that. We've obviously got the grey slate, which again is standard on the new base camps as of 2023. And it just looks contemporary, it looks stylish, it looks modern. So overall, what do I think to the new Basecamp Evo concept? Obviously, I absolutely love it. I love that there has now been thought made about the sustainability of the manufacturing process and where they're going to source all the fittings and fixtures from. Now, I'm not saying it's perfect. I'm not saying it's ready to go to market exactly as it is. I'm not saying there's not hurdles to overcome. But what I really, really, really applaud Swift for here is attempting to improve and do something better. At number three, we have the Bailey Discovery D44L, which was a popular choice last year on my list, but this year we got to try it out in person. We travelled down to the Bailey of Bristol factory and picked up this shiny new prototype Bailey Discovery D44L, and they very kindly let us take it away for a proper thorough live-in test, which was a first for my channel. I'll pop a link to this test in the video description and in the video itself, because you really need to check out the full thing to find out just why this caravan was so great. But it's a new concept from Bailey, which has been sort of retweaked in recent years to just make it a little bit more practical. And I think the thing that impressed me most about this is it tries to challenge conventionality, while at the same time managing to do a lot of things that caravans at twice its £21,500 price point don't do quite as well. What impressed us was the long kitchen inside, which gave you plenty of space to prep and plenty of storage, and also the small washroom area, which doubled as a bit of an airing cupboard. Because of the small dimensions of the caravan, Bailey have had to really think hard about how they organize the interior, particularly when it comes to shelving and storage, and this was just one of the things that really impressed me about this caravan. But overall, it's a fun little cozy getaway and I really enjoyed using it. And I know it was our first live-in test, but I've used plenty of modern caravans before, and this caravan just impressed me so much that I will wholeheartedly recommend it as a caravan that you should consider if you want something quirky, cool or unusual. At number two, we've got a new entry from Knaus, and this comes all the way from Germany, but it will be on sale in Britain officially in 2024. With the Yaseo range, Knaus are trying to push caravan design forward to the next level and really keep in mind what the future requirements are going to be from a leisure caravan once we move over to electric vehicles in a more prominent way. This caravan is really carrying the torch to lead the charge with, you pardon the pun, with what the future of caravans will possibly look like. So the body shell on the Knaus Yaseo is just 3.4 meters long. So it's tiny, it's really, really compact. And this is something that we're going to be seeing more of in the future. Caravans need to get lighter and smaller and more aerodynamic to improve the range of the towing vehicle. So Knaus have really had to think hard about how they cram everything that we would expect to find in a caravan into such a comparatively short body shell. But there's a lot of things on this van that you'll find that you won't find on normal caravans. And you'll see straight away here, we've got a large conventional entrance door. And here, this isn't a second entrance door for small people. It is actually the entrance to the garage space, which is actually also the interior of the caravan. So lots of other caravans, including other offerings by Knaus, have a separate garage at the front, which is, I wouldn't say it's dead space because it's storage space after all, but with this, they've been even smarter and given you direct access in a more accessible way if you're trying to put a bike or something through there to the living space, which obviously when you're towing, doesn't really matter, you can use it. So you'll find there's a door on this side, but if we step around this way, there is also another door on the other side that does exactly the same thing. And at the moment, the sofas are made up into their daytime position, but during towing, you can fold them away, which I'll show you in a moment. And then you've got clear access through there to put bikes. They've even fitted charging points for your electric bikes if you put them in the caravan there as well. I just think it's such a clever idea. And again, on such a small space, it's really clever use of design. The first thing that you see as soon as you step inside the Knaus Yaseo 340 is the kitchen, and it is a small compact space as you would expect to find in a caravan of this size. But that's not to say they've not been quite clever in how it all slots together. And top of the list for me are marks for innovation is they've actually used a compressor fridge to fit here, which is a lot better than other manufacturers who are going all electric are just using a standard electric fridge. The compressor fridge will actually run from a leisure battery and will run perfectly well from your vehicle battery as well. It's a much more expensive fitting, so that's why I'm surprised to find it. And I know it is one of the options on the list, which has a significant impact on the price of the van. But this is the kind of technology that we need to see in caravans going forward to reduce power consumption and just enable you to be more free to use the caravan off grid. We've got an induction hob here with two rings on it. We've got a small sink here and a lovely black tap. I love the, this is the thing with Knaus. Obviously they're a German manufacturer. Everything's high quality. Everything is stylish and everything looks modern and sleek. And it's just little things like these that you tend to not find in British caravans that just make this a more interesting space. But in terms of clever design, it's got something which I've never seen before on a caravan, and it's a concealed little rack down here, which I guess could be a spice rack or something, that just pops up from behind here, which is brilliant. It's so simple, and just it required a little bit of thought to execute, but it works really well, because if you don't need what's in there, you can push it back down and have some extra worktop space if you wish. Next to the kitchen, we'll find the washroom. And this is one of my favorite bits of the van, actually, because it's kind of like a little boutique hotel washroom. It's very, very nicely finished off indeed. I love the black paneling that they use. It sort of looks like contemporary slate. And there's tons of storage in here. Even like above the toilet, there's a little space there to put towels. There's concealed cupboards behind the mirror here at the top. And even down by the sink, we've got these built-in separators where you can put your toothbrush, soaps, etc. And we've finally got the heating vent at the back here, because the heating is funneled into the washroom. It's in the back end of the Knaus Yaseo 340 PX where things get the most interesting. Now, if you've watched my channel for a long time, you'll know that I love vintage caravans. And one of the things that was really, really popular in the 50s and 60s in Britain and abroad was a tip-up bed. So I'm delighted to see that one has returned here for the Knaus Yaseo range. But just before we go on to that, there's a couple more things to mention. The seating is modular. So we mentioned before that it's got the locker door access to the outside. These seat cushions can move out of the way quite easily, and they reveal storage boxes underneath, so that you can have the clear space to get through with your bikes, surfboards, etc. So the moment of truth, the tip-up bed. This is the thing that everyone's been waiting for, and it is a fantastic design. Back in the 60s, they used to use like a magazine rack as the leg. This uses the support of the bunks, but unlike 60s versions where you had to take all the cushions and put them on the floor, we just have to move two on this side. Press one button and with one arm can pull the bed down very, very easily, like so. And the bed is a really generous size. It's just a little bit under 5 foot wide by about 6'4" long. So there's plenty of space in this bed. It's very, very generously sized, because that used to be an issue with tip-up beds and caravans, that the beds were very small. Caravans have obviously got round that through clever adjustment of proportions and things, and it's perfectly usable and actually really comfortable bed. It's got a lightweight foam mattress on it, so you can tow the van with the bed in the up position. Quite often, if they had a sprung mattress on them, you would have to lower them for towing to just distribute the weight more evenly. But again, Caravans have thought about that, and it's got this clever pocket memory foam mattress that uses a combination of the foam and the bed slats beneath to make it more comfortable to sleep on. I just can't believe a caravan this small has so much packed into it, and Knaus continuing to push the envelope with design. And I'm not saying that this is absolutely perfect and this model singularly is the true future of caravanning for everyone, but there's so many ideas here that need to be adopted by more manufacturers to help push caravan design forwards. So my caravan of the year 2024 is the La Mancelle Liberty 440 PC, which comes all the way from France. And I've talked about this caravan lots on my channel, but in the summer months of 2023, we actually got to take one away and live in it for the weekend. These are exclusively imported by Marquis Leisure, who have outlets all over the country, predominantly more so in the south. I'll pop a link to their website in the description below if you want to check them out further, because there are other models in the range. But the Liberty Plaisance is the top of the range model, but this is the smallest one that they're offering in Britain. And there is so much to love about this caravan, from its quirky looks to its unusual styling. It's just like nothing else on the road. But the overriding thing that impressed me most about this was just the unbelievable level of attention to detail that has gone into this caravan. From its polyester, almost monocoque construction, right through to its UV resistant graphics, this caravan is designed for longevity. It's supposed to be a caravan that you can buy and keep for a long time. And La Mancelle appears to be one of the few manufacturers in the world that are focusing on this. And as we move to be more sustainable and cut down our carbon footprint, we need to be buying vehicles that will last longer and break less. And the La Mancelle assures me that it will do just that. The really nice thing about the interior of the Mancelle is it's so spacious, bright and airy. The caravan is only 6.38 meters long overall, and that's comparatively small compared to a lot of the standard vans that we buy in Britain, yet it just feels so open and spacious in here. It's a fairly standard width at 2.25 meters wide, so you can't even have the excuse that it's 8 foot wide and it's giving you space. It's just clever design. The soft colour of the wood, the bright white worktops, the light upholstery, the way they've used the windows to tunnel the light into the caravan, the huge central skylight and this massive front opening window just make it feel really bright and airy in here. And I know people are saying, oh, you can't see the view out very easily. You can when you're stood up and walking around sort of by the kitchen or in the wardrobe or whatever. You can very clearly see out the front window, but I actually quite like the fact that it feels a bit private in here. It's not like you're sat in a fishbowl. Walking around the campsite, I mean, obviously we're just on a fairly bog standard campsite here, so there's no views or vistas to take in. But when I was wandering around, everyone's either sat outside or sat inside their caravan with their backs to the front windows watching their telly. So I kind of don't understand this argument of you need to see the view out. I actually like the sense of privacy that this caravan affords you. Combined with the tinted windows from the outside, people can't really see what's going on in here. And that is what I think is one of its really big plus points. It's unconventional and it's unusual, but it's still bright, spacious and airy. And if you want to see the view, you can stand up and gaze at it for 5 minutes. But I think this seating arrangement lends more in terms of usability compared to having a big front window to focus on. This is brilliant for getting your friends to sit round. And even if you're just on your own or just as a couple, you can still put your feet up towards the side and enjoy a cozy, comfortable space. And it just works from every angle, this front lounge. And trust the French to turn conventionality on its head and make something like this in a caravan. I think it's wonderful. Of course, France is the country of food, so how does the kitchen compare? Well, straight away, I will say there is not a tremendous amount of worktop space in it, but there is a big caveat here. The original French design has a hob top on here that still allows you plenty of workspace, but for the British market, they've had to fit a British oven, grill, and 3-burner hob on top, which is just a bog standard Thetford model that we're well used to seeing in British vans here. Now, this has even ruffled the feathers of the French caravanning press, who've actually published an article saying, of course, when the Mancelle comes to Britain, it needs an oven so the British can have their roast dinner. And I love it when the French roast us, because sometimes we really do deserve it. And this is one of those things. British people love a lot of spec in their vans, but you're constantly hearing that, I don't use my microwave, I don't use my oven, yet we just love to have them anyway. So if cooking is your thing, you've got a full normal Thetford oven, grill and separate hob in here. But there's a few touches that you won't find in many British caravans at all, if any, such as this touchscreen extractor fan straight above the cooker, which funnels fumes outside through a vent in the side of the caravan. It's got a light, a down light for the cooker, so you can see what you're doing. It also has a clock and a built-in timer on it. So it's a really clever little thoughtful addition to the caravan there. Other little nice touches include this point up here where you can put your dish cloth and your washing up liquid just up off the worktop, out of the way. A really small but very important detail. Having your washing up liquid on the side takes up space, so Mancelle have lifted it high up out of the way. You'll find other European manufacturers such as Adria do this, but for some reason in Britain we don't. Not sure why. It's got a fairly standard round sink with a nice folding glass top, and this tap is exquisite quality. It's not the sort of fitting that we typically see in the caravan industry in Britain. It feels like you could probably hang a rope off it and climb up onto the kitchen from it. It's so strong and sturdy, which again is the theme throughout this caravan. It's time to move on to the boudoir, and in true French style, this is a really sensual place to be. Before this turns into carry-on camping like most of my videos seem to, I'm just going to get on and tell you what's great about this part of the caravan. You've noticed straight away it's a real stylistic contrast from the front end that has the turquoise and the very sparse wall coverings. Instead, we've got curtains, we've got fly nets and these lovely opening curtains which divide the bedroom off from the living area. Now, every British caravan you ever see, regardless of the price, has one of those horrible hearing aid beige concertina stupid things on a track that as soon as you open it, it just comes straight off, or you've got to manually bunch it back up, and it's just not really a very nice fitting at all, yet manufacturers seem to love fitting them. This, on the other hand, is a really simple idea. It's probably cost less money, to be fair, but it just adds that certain style and flair that we're learning the Mancelle is all about. I love it. Apart from making jokes about doing the can-can through the middle of it, it does actually make the space feel very cozy and warm, and such a nice vibe when you're sat back here. There's just tons of storage, all soft shut cupboards, and when we've been talking about the quality of this van, another thing that's impressed me is all the cupboards line up. All the panel gaps are the same. If you bought a British van, you will know that's one of the first things that you have to wrangle when you get one. Yet Mancelle have managed to do it beautifully here from the factory with no tweaks or snagging list necessary. So again, I just have to commend them. It's a fantastic design. If I had £38,000 to spend on a caravan, I would put it on this. Very safe in the knowledge that I could have it as long as I wished. I wouldn't have to be thinking about replacing it in 3 years because it would wear out or leak or have issues with it. I have every single confidence, having used it this weekend, combined with my experience of using so many other caravans over the years, I have every confidence that you could buy this as a lifetime investment and you could keep it 10, 20, maybe even 30 years or more. We know that the French have a great reputation for building strong caravans that last a very long time. And I certainly believe this Mancelle is a true credit to the manufacturer. Oh, I think we should resume to a bit of French culture and enjoy a cheese course. So there we have it. That was my list of the 5 coolest new caravans that are in Britain for 2024. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below and let me know if you agree with them. I'm hoping this year we'll get to look at a few more in depth. I've really enjoyed doing these live-in tests because it gives you such a great opportunity to just get really down to the nitty-gritty about whether these caravans work or not. I've just got to pass on my thanks for this video to Bailey of Bristol for lending us the Discovery, to Marquis Caravans who lent us the La Mancelle Liberty, and to the Caravan and Motorhome Club who've put us up on their campsites for the live-in tests and also helped us out at the NEC Caravan and Motorhome Show. If you've enjoyed today's video, please do subscribe and like the video. Let me know what you think in the comments below, and I'll see you again very soon.